I'm Claire McWhirter and I'm principal scientist at Artios Pharma. I lead the biochemistry and screening team there. Artios Pharma was founded in 2016. We're a biotech startup and we're focused on developing the next generation of DNA damage repair inhibitors. Within the biochemistry and screening team, we're primarily responsible for all the protein production, assay development, screening and entomology that goes on within Artios Pharma. And so this means we have a wider range of assays that we need to both develop and then run within our group. In terms of the work that we do, we run both stopped and kinetic assays, and they're often fluorescence-based, but we do also do some work with FP and luminescence-based assays. So for us, the major benefit of the ClarioStar Plus was that it has a monochromator. So within the group, the DNA damage repair field, it's quite a new field compared to things like kinases and GPCRs, which often have a lot of off-the-shelf platforms and reagents available to us. So we're often developing novel assays from scratch. For us, the monochromator and the ClarioStar Plus gave us the flexibility that we don't have to worry about having the right filters in the lab. We know that we can always use the monochromator and we'll have the right wavelengths that we need. We also really liked the extended dynamic range that's available on the ClarioStar Plus. So this has enabled us to do kinetic assays much more quickly and in much more detail, because often when you're carrying out fluorescence-based assays, you have problems with either maxing out the detectors at high substrate concentrations or losing the data quality at low substrate concentrations if you try and do the full range in one go. Whereas with the extended dynamic range, we don't have this issue anymore, so we can do all our kinetic characterization or inhibitor characterization experiments in one plate at the same time. So this has been a huge benefit for us. So within drug discovery over the past 5 years or so, I think there's been a real recognition that as we move away from well-established target classes such as kinases and GPCRs, we really need to understand what both our proteins and inhibitors are doing to help with translation of these really quite novel targets from biochemical assays into cell assays and then further on into in vivo work and even into the clinic. And so there's been a real push to develop more detailed high throughput kinetic assays so we can really bring this kind of characterization much earlier within the drug discovery process and make much more informed decisions about the translation that we're seeing from biochemical assays into cell assays and understanding the effects that we're seeing that we might not understand as well as we do with more established fields such as kinases.